Kessler? Kessler? Kessler! Do you like your job? Do you?
Well, yes.
Then just what the hell do you think you're doing?
Making it better.
Look, you know our demographics. Adolescents 10 to 15.
Yes, I know, but aren't we trying to sell to girls, too?
So, what is this, some sort of feminist statement?
No more than blonde hair, big breasts, and peekaboo skins are a racist, sexist statement.
Change it back.
Edwin, it took me a long time to get it there.
Time doing unauthorized work again. You know, when are you gonna get it through your head? We make games. You know, bloodbaths, shoot 'em ups, not mist. And for your information, adolescent boys happen to like big breasts and peekaboo skins.
Guess you know.
I am the designer. You are a pixel adjuster. Just follow orders. Change it back every panel by Monday.
Oh, God, I'm beginning to hate this place.
Nazi dweeb.
You know what he called me? A pixel adjuster.
Clever. Coming from someone with bite-sized wit.
Oh, God, when does it all end?
Not in this lifetime, babe.
Oh, thank you, little Mary Sunshine. You're supposed to be perking me up, remember? Tell me to go for it. Find my passion.
No, you want passion, you go fall in love.
A man, Louis Pasteur's solution to everything.
Tall, hairy, handsome.
Tall, dark, and handsome. Sometimes I just lie in my bed and I think, what happened? Where's my life?
Hi, you've reached the Kesslers, Gwen and Sean. So tell us, what's on your mind?
Yeah, what's on my mind is, when are you going to change that message? Sean, you there?
We do not screen messages from our mother, remember?
Okay, honey, I'm going to be late.
Fight with the dweeb, sorry. I'll be home as soon as I can.
I love you. Bye.
Don't stay here all night, right? Why don't you come by the gallery later? That way your evening won't be a complete bust.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Bye. Hey, maybe I should make this dragon anatomically correct, huh? Bye.
Hi, honey, I'm home.
Hi, Mom.
Bad day at the office. I'm miserable. Sorry about the movie, sweetie. Hi.
I rented us a video.
Oh, you're good. Uh-huh. Hey, you didn't use a credit card, did you?
Cash. Come on, let's see. What?
No, nothing. Hey, what were you doing when I called?
Composing.
My mother always thinks she knows what's best, okay? All right, I think she's right. Because her greater years
have given her exaggerated fears.
All right. Exaggerated fears.
It's a sonnet. You'll have to rhyme with best.
Okay. Truce. Not on an empty stomach. Let's do this later.
Want to watch a movie while we eat?
Sure.
What? I thought Harrison was your favorite.
No, video's fine, honey.
You don't want to?
No, I said it's fine.
Keep saying that.
Well, Louis did invite me to a gallery opening tonight.
We're supposed to be going out to a movie.
I know, but then I had to work late, and I don't know, I just thought,
Oh, come on. Come on, don't do this.
Do what? What am I doing?
You know what you're doing. You're making me feel guilty. Come on. How many gallery openings do I get invited to? Who knows, I might get discovered.
Only if you take your drawings.
Discovered to have wit, charm, and inner beauty.
By some guy.
So? Listen, honey, I know. I promised we'd spend the evening together, but would you really mind?
What? Staying home by myself?
I'll make it up to you, I promise.
I don't want you to make it up to me.
Oh, really? Okay, what is it you do want?
I thought this was supposed to be an art gallery.
Nice. Hey.
Oh, thank God.
But I thought your field was poetry.
Slumber.
Sean.
Enjoy. I'm so glad you came.
Because
the girl who was supposed to handle the buffet over here stood me up, and Danny is kind of furious. And
no.
No.
Come on. Louis, I came here to mingle with artists and to pass cheese dip.
Gwen, please, I'm desperate. I'm going to do it myself. I have been doing it myself. You know, Danny expects me to mingle and stimulate sales. I know. But she'd be amazed what some people will do with their discretionary income. Gwen, please, I'll owe you. Big time.
Okay, okay. Thank you. Okay, but just for 1 hour. And no apron.
No, not
some Chardonnay, some of the little cheese things, some sandwiches.
You know, you may serve yourself.
Well, may I?
Mom. Hey, honey, how's it going?
I'm boring.
Shh. You should have brought your stuff. It's a lot better than this.
No doubt.
May I help you?
Yes, can I have some of those cheese things and some sandwiches and a refill, please?
Sure.
Thank you. So you're not into conceptual art?
You'll have to excuse my son. In fact, would you excuse us for a moment, please?
Thank you.
Sean? Hey, what did I do?
You are embarrassing me.
I sketched. This is real art.
Yeah, well, now I've seen it. Can we please go?
No, we cannot go.
What more than I want? Hi, occupied. Try the men's. Everything okay?
Is everything okay? You're in here snorting cocaine. You're asking me if it... You know Sean's out there.
Oh. That's better.
It's a really great-looking guy. Just mistook me for the hired help. Oh, get that away from me. So that's the last thing I need to be is more uptight.
That's uptown. This is downtown.
Downtown?
Sometimes you are such a naive. It's heroin.
Heroin? Louis!
You stop. Can't you see all those old junky stereotypes stumbling around your head?
You're out of your mind.
No, not anymore. Color me relaxed. It's no worse than booze.
It's illegal.
You know, so was alcohol during Prohibition. And this is a lot less destructive, socially and physically.
Now he's being naive. It's addicting.
Oh, come on. Yeah, and killer weed will turn you right into a sex fiend. Come on, hey, do I look like I'm hooked? Just take a little hit, a couple times a week, just mellow right out. It's like a body experience. It's the perfect antidote to a rotten day.
I don't believe you.
I'm crushed. But if you change your mind...
I won't.
Are we ready?
Please, no more cheese dip.
Go, charm. Mingle with the mediocre. See if I care.
Thank you.
The act of creation is as important, actually, probably it's more important than the object of beauty itself, which meant... Hello.
Hi.
Now can we go?
In a while. Excuse him. What were you saying?
What I was going to say is, hi, I'm Nat Corelli. How do you do?
Oh, hi, Gwen Kessler.
Gwen, hi. And the other thing that I was going to say was, would you have dinner with me tomorrow?
Dinner?
She's got plans.
Actually, honey, you're the one with plans. You remember going to see your father? Do I know you?
No, but your friends do.
And this is my business card. See, it looks just like me if you hold it like this. Here.
Dinner tomorrow. Yeah, sure. Sounds great. Seven?
Seven sold.
Okay.
I'll be there.
Okay.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.
Child support insurance. That's all I asked, Jerry.
I like being behind. You think I planned this?
No, you never plan anything.
You just have to do this to me, don't you? Go and undercut my self-esteem just when I'm coming to pick up Sean so that it taints the whole weekend.
I'm sorry. That's not my intention, really. It's just that my savings are gone. The car needs fixing, and my credit cards are maxed out.
I'm looking for work, okay?
I know you are. I'm sure you're doing the best you can. No, seriously, no sarcasm, really. It's just after all the bills are paid, I barely have enough for laundry and groceries.
Half of all I got.
Thank you.
You know, it'd be a lot cheaper if we got back together again.
Oh, Jerry, please. Don't even go there. Have fun.
Yeah.
Kathy, sweetie, not on the floor. Fold some clothes for Mommy.
He's not a bad guy, really. He's just ineffectual.
That's a little harsh.
That's why I said it, so you don't have to.
Gwen, the guy's a grown-up. At least he's supposed to be. He's got responsibilities, and you're not doing him or you or Sean any favor by letting him off the hook.
Yeah, well, he's doing the best he can. Oh, damn, these machines. Look at this. Didn't drain. I gotta go into work today.
Relax, I'll put those in the dryer for you. Then when you come back, you can buy me a cappuccino.
Thank you. Oh, wait, I can't. I have a date.
A date? What is a date? I forgot. Lucky you.
Yeah. Knock for Micah.
Kessler. What are you doing here?
You said to have this change back by Monday.
Gwen is one of our artistes. Rupert Patel.
Very pleased to be meeting you.
Hi.
Rupert starts next week. In fact, you'll be training him.
To do what?
Why, what you do, of course.
Hello? Hi, Doris. I don't know. Why don't you just leave him? I can't leave right now. My boss just walked in. I have to finish this work. Okay. Yeah, I'll call you later. Thanks. Bye.
Okay.
Who steals t-shirts? Sheets.
I'm sure sorry. I thought it belonged to those guys. You sure you're okay, hon?
I'm fine. Beautiful.
I've got that for you. Here.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Come on in.
Wow, great place.
Oh, thanks. You know, I tried to call you, but I didn't have your number.
But didn't I give you a card? I gave you a business card. Do you want another card?
No,
you want another one?
You did. Oh, it's just been one of those days.
I'd love to hear about it.
No, you wouldn't believe me. In fact, I feel awful about this, but I was wondering if maybe we could have a rain check.
Sure, but, you know, it doesn't have to be anything elaborate. I mean, you're gonna eat anyway. You do eat, don't you?
I haven't even gotten beyond a hot bath.
Well, so why don't you go take the bath, and if you're still not up for it later, we'll just...
You sure?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Good.
Okay, thanks.
Get clean.
Ugh.
She is.
I'm sorry. I guess I must have fallen asleep.
Well, I wouldn't wake you, but this stuff is better if you eat it in the same decade that you cooked it. You know?
I'll just go get dressed.
No. That's one of the joys of eating in your own house. You can come as you are. No dress code. Here you go. Right here.
Okay. Wow.
So, who's the poet?
Oh, that's Sean. That's just a little game we play. Artists need encouragement, you know. My parents, on the other hand, thought that I should study something practical. Unfortunately, I was a compliant child, so that's how I ended up doing computer games. Sex and violence for prepubescent boys. Oh, God, I don't want to talk about that. What about you?
Me? Mm-hmm. I'm an electrician. And I think of art actually as a way to combine interests of computers and music and cars.
Cars? What kind of cars?
Are you up for a little excitement?
Always. You race these things?
After I build them.
You build these things?
No. Yes, I build them. Do you want to try?
Yeah.
Okay, go this way. House the carts, and then Lewis told me about this place.
Wow.
Well? So, it's kind of a mess, but it's pretty cool. It takes me about 6 weeks to clean it, so. So, you want some wine?
Sure, I'll get it.
All right, the wine is in there, there's glasses, and good luck. Funny, everything okay?
Yep.
Touch it.
How did you do that?
It's a trade secret, I tell you, if you invest about 23 hours here. Cheers. Wanna go sit in the living room?
Sure. Who's the woman up on the bulletin board?
Oh, that's Helen, my wife. She died.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thank you.
How long ago?
4 years ago.
And the quote, my calamity is my...
My providence is my calamity. And outwardly it is fire and vengeance. Inwardly, it's mercy and light. Hmm. Kind of nice, huh? It's something I try to remember when I'm feeling a little sorry for myself. Sit down.
About?
Oh. Helen was an alcoholic, but I was as addicted to her as she was to booze, so that was my calamity.
The providence?
Lessons learned. You know, why I chose self-destructive women and trying to watch for the signals and make sure I don't make the same mistake again.
Yeah, about self-pity, I know what you mean.
Yeah.
And if I didn't have friends like Lewis
to
kick me in the every once in a while. He thinks you're a hunk, by the way.
Ooh, I don't know if I should be flattered or alarmed.
Oh, well, given Lewis's standards, definitely flattered.
Alarmed, yeah.
No, flattered, yeah. Definitely.
I'm sorry.
No, it's me. It's, you know, you said about making the same mistake over and over again, but...
Stop. I would really like you to be here in the morning. So, will you sleep with me? Just sleep. I want to hold you. No moving, no talking, just... Is this okay for you?
Yeah. How about you?
Morning.
Morning.
Don't go away. Table for two.
This is great.
Orange juice?
Yeah, thanks. Where'd you get all this food?
Can we talk about last night?
No, you don't have to say anything. It's fine. No.
Yeah, I do need to.
Okay.
In the past, I've tried to disguise the realities of my life, which aren't easy. No money, very little time, a kid, and it hasn't worked out. So I've decided. And my friend Doris thinks I'm crazy, but I've decided I'm going to tell the truth. And if there's interest, then it will be based on brutal reality. Yes.
There's interest.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I mean, come on, we all come with baggage. I mean, my brutal truth is that Helen may have killed herself in a DUI, but by me staying with her, me trying to rescue her, I was just enabling her right into the grave. So maybe I should be the one asking you if you're sure.
Remember.
white t-shirts?
Oh, it was stolen.
What do you mean stolen?
Yeah, I had to leave our clothes at the laundromat, and when I came back, someone had stolen some sheets and your shirts.
Back from where?
Work.
You're right.
Hey. You mind telling me what's going on?
Someone stole my shirt, okay?
Yeah, well, what's the innuendo about my whereabouts, anyway?
Work at midnight and 6 a.m.?
You were checking up on me.
You check up on me?
I'm the parent.
When did you get home?
Do I look like I need a monitor?
Maybe a chaperone.
A chaperone? Think I need a chaperone? You want to be my chaperone? You want to be my chap? Okay, honey, listen. I told you before, and nothing has changed. My private life is my own. But I promised you, and I meant it. I will not bring someone into this family without...
my consent.
Consultation. Besides, I don't want you to judge Nat until you've met
Nat?
Him. Nat.
As in Natty?
Well, he's a pretty cool guy.
Oh, if she does say so herself.
Yeah, if I do say so myself, and I do say so myself. And come here, I think you need a noogie really, 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 really badly. Shall you?
Stop.
You better?
Please. Good morning, Jane.
Betty, from personnel. Oh. I mean, whoops, excuse me. Human resources says that a lot of companies are hiring these third world programmers because they'll work cheap and then never rock the boat lest they lose the green card.
Oh, wonderful. Indentured servants.
Mm-hmm. Now, how's it doing?
Good. A little too good.
Oh, come on. You need to eat something to make you feel better. We're going to send out for Chinese. Mm. Can we get you something? You and your new best friend back there?
No, thanks. Maybe you could get me some more of that surprise gift.
Shh. The walls have ears. Was that right? Was that right?
Oh, man. Mm-hmm. Oh, it was so mellow. It was a total body experience. Great.
Oh, I'm so sorry. No more. But I'm going to give you a number. And ask for Hal.
Hal, okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
He's good looking, he works, you like the same stuff, the sex is great. Excuse me, did I miss something? What's the problem?
Well, he still has to pass the kid test.
Okay, fair enough. But at least Sean won't pee on him.
I just like the poor guy had no more sat down when Patsy climbed up on his lap and had an accident.
Which is just as well. I got to find out he had no sense of humor.
What?
I don't know. Maybe I'm just afraid he's going to find out the truth.
You told him the truth.
What? Gwen, repeat after me. I am smart, pretty, blonde, stuck, broke, floundering, lost. Give yourself a break and him. Will you take some deep breaths and reflect on your good fortune? Seriously. Patsy, come on, honey. Time to go.
I almost ate out of my hand.
I saw.
But, thanks.
Yeah. Come on. Watch your step. Did you like those ducks?
Help, please.
Do you ever drive one of those?
Where is my mom?
She's in the bathroom. Here, you want some?
Mom!
I'm coming! It's impolite to yell at people in the bathroom.
Can we please go now?
Go? We just got here. Now, come on, you go check out the cars, and I'll get lunch, okay?
All right, your carriageway's here. Step on here. Come on, step on here. Let's get ready.
Okay, let's see what we got here. Oh! Ow!
Mom? I'm just so dumb. I'm so sorry.
Come on. No, really, it doesn't hurt.
This doesn't hurt? Come on.
No, at least let me clean it up.
Leave it.
I'll do it. I got it.
Stupid, it really doesn't hurt.
He's being such a jerk.
Oh, it'll be fine. He's a great kid. Just relax.
So I stayed in the bathroom a while, you know. I wanted you guys to have a chance to relate.
Yeah. Would you just let me take care of it, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Seriously. There.
Mm.
Is that all right?
Yeah, thank you. Hey!
So, you okay?
Yeah, it's just minor.
I saved most of it.
Great, let's eat.
So, you know about cars, huh?
Well, go-karts. Cars, the engines are a little more complex.
Why? Are you interested?
No, not really. I just thought, if you know so much, maybe you could check out our car.
Why? What's wrong with it?
No, there's nothing. Well, nothing a couple hundred dollars wouldn't fix. I didn't mean that.
But, Mom, we've got the money.
My accountant here. That's your something special fund, honey. And we came here for lunch anyway, not to catch favors, okay?
No, it wouldn't be a favor. It would be my pleasure. It's what I do.
No, thank you anyway. Stop rescuing.
All right. Listen.
Here, let me do this. Before I ask your mom if she's willing to give up your help with the laundry, I thought I'd check with you. I have to take one of the carts out to the track this afternoon, and I was wondering if you'd like to help me, unless you'd like to spend your whole day dealing with static cling.
Yeah, sure, I guess.
Good.
$200 for my birthday from my mother. She must have just remembered something really horrible she did to me as a child.
I'm in your present, right, Mommy?
You sure are. And the coffee today is on me. Are you about ready?
Yeah. Doris, I'm really kind of embarrassed to ask this, but I was wondering if maybe I could borrow $20 just till next week.
What is to be embarrassed?
Of course.
In fact, how about 40?
Because I'm so rich. Please.
Thank you.
Mommy, I have to go wee-wee.
Sure, honey. Would you watch my stuff? Gwen, we're all short now and then. It's no big deal.
Is the brake, all right? Gas, brake. Don't go too fast. And go get him.
I got Pale Horse, Lethal Weapon, and Special Delivery.
Pale Horse, 20.
20? How am I gonna pay my tuition? Besides, I told you, volume gives you more bang for the buck.
That's all I have.
About 3 for $25, and I'll throw in a couple syringes.
Not interested.
Smart. Deal?
Deal.
Hey, I'm not taking your gas money, am I? Or food out of your kid's mouth, because like I told you before, I'm sure we could work something out.
Yeah, in your dreams.
Yeah. You want some gratuitous advice? Free because I like you so much. Chase the dragon, less waste, more high. You don't know what I'm talking about, do you?
No, thanks.
Hi. Sorry I'm taking so long.
Where are you?
Mom?
I just met. Here he is.
Hi, honey. Still at the laundromat.
We're invited for dinner.
All right. Give it to me. Give it to me. Hey, hello.
Sounds like you guys are getting along great.
Yeah, so far so good.
I'll be there in half an hour, okay? Love you. Oops.
Oops yourself. Me too. Me too.
Bye.
All right.
Not to pay child support, because it will be me he's hauling into court, not you. Oh, Sean! Sean! Sean!
Don't come in!
Sean, I'm sorry.
What's wrong with you? You're up half the night and you yell all the time.
I'm anxious about things. I'm about work and bills and the car.
Then use my money to fix the damn thing.
Hey, I'm trying to apologize here, all right? If I've been taking my troubles out on you, I don't mean to. But there is no way I'm letting you use your savings account. And there's no way I'm letting you get out of your visit with your dad. You forget something?
What's that smell?
Oh, plastic. I dropped some plastic on the stove.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too. Thank you. Listen, if you don't want to go to your dad's, that's fine.
It is? But you said...
Your dad will understand.
You think?
I know. So you call Nat, find out if it's okay with him, and then I want you to call your dad, okay?
Great. Mom? Are you okay?
Me? Yeah. I'm fine.
Thank you.
$7, $8, $9.
Is that all?
Yes, ma'am. The roll wasn't full. Is there something else I can help you with?
Yeah. Take $100 out of that. Make it $200.
That'll close it.
Okay. What do you got?
Special D.
Is it pure?
As white as you.
100.
Big spender.
Everybody's got a hunger. No matter where.
She's kind of been having trouble sleeping at night and
yeah.
Kind of been forgetting things, you know?
Hey, everybody!
Oh,
no. Hi, guys. I'm so sorry the car broke down again. I had to do my errands by bus, and then I had to bring all the stuff back to the car. I'm so sorry. Hi.
Hi. Mm. Want some pizza?
Nah, thanks. Then I finally got back to the car. Yeah. Finally started, thank God. Then I realized what time it was, and I didn't call you, and I'm just so sorry.
Mm. Want some ice cream?
Nah, not for me, thanks.
Uh-oh! Would you like to run down to the corner and get some, huh?
Sure, what kind?
Your choice. Here you go. Okay, be careful.
All right.
Bye, honey. So, how was your day? What?
What's going on?
What do you mean, what's going on? I told you my car broke down.
These past couple of weeks, I've been trying to figure out what's been bugging me. All these strange behavior, all these excuses. And then it hit me, deja vu, just like Helen.
What do you think, I'm a closet drunk?
I don't know what to think. Let's see. Let's see, you let Sean skip a visit with his dad. You
oh,
disappear for a whole day, and then you show up late again. And just let me finish! I hear that you're not sleeping. I hear that you're not eating. You got Sean all worried about you, so why don't you tell me what's going on?
Nothing. Nothing is going on. And just because of something that happened in your past, it doesn't give you the right to go around accusing me.
I'm accusing you? I am asking you, what are you on?
What am I on? What am I on?
Don't jack me around! There's plenty of guys out there who turn a blind eye to this kind of
blind.
Class, but not me.
Paranoid.
Oh, I'm paranoid.
Yeah.
Here, show me what's in your purse.
My purse?
Yeah, yeah.
You go to hell.
You got some reason not to, do you?
Yeah, I got some reason not to. I'm not gonna buy into your craziness. If you can't trust me, if you are incapable of trusting anybody, then fine! It's over!
You look me straight in the eyes and you tell me the truth!
The truth about what? You gave me a 1 instead of a 10.
Sean, we're out of here!
What?
Mom, move!
But Mom!
Move!
What?
Don't argue with me, just go!
Why do we have to leave? What happened?
Just get in the car.
What did he do? What the hell did he do?
He wanted me to about my purse, okay? Sean! Damn it!
So, why didn't you?
Why didn't I what?
Dump out your purse. I mean, what's the big deal?
The big deal is, I'm not gonna let a man dictate my life. Not now, and not ever. That includes you.
I don't know what's going on, but I think I deserve an explanation. Sean called and left me a message and said that he isn't coming for his regular visit, and I...
Call him.
Mom!
Call him and apologize. Tell him you'll see him tomorrow.
You're the one he wants to talk to.
Can't you ever just do what you're told? I'm exhausted. I'm just gonna take a shower and go to bed. If he wants to talk to me, tell him I'll call him tomorrow.
I tell you, if she doesn't know, come to me.
Yes, sir, but I was certain that we had it.
She was out sick.
Is that a crime?
Don't push it, Kessler.
As for you, I expect this damage repaired by the end of the day.
Yes, sir.
What a jerk.
Don't you think you owe Rupert an apology?
That's not necessary.
What's your problem?
None of this would have happened if you had kept your mind on business. Or been here.
Hey, I have 5 weeks, count them, 5 weeks accumulated sick days.
Rupert, would you excuse us for just a minute, please?
Certainly.
When's the last time you looked in the mirror?
What's that supposed to mean?
You're so high right now, huh?
I am not.
Are you hooked?
Just because a person takes a few drinks a couple times a week doesn't mean she's an alcoholic.
How much money and how many of your sick days have you spent on these few drinks? What do you take me for, a fool?
No. Little old lady who should mind his own business. Besides, you were the one that turned me on to begin with.
You think I don't feel responsible?
Oh. Listen, Lewis. Chill. I appreciate your concern. I really do. It's just that it's not necessary, because I can quit anytime I want.
Really? Then you gotta start right now.
Oh, gosh.
I know what it is.
How's that?
Guys, it's school. Will you talk to her?
No.
She misses you. I know she does.
I miss her, and I miss you too, but talking is not gonna help.
You don't know that until you try.
I have tried, Sean. I've tried. The best thing you can do is just stay out of this. Why don't you go live with your dad for a while?
Run away? Is that what you're gonna do? Crap out? Just because she made a mistake?
This is not a mistake. This is more than a mistake. It's an addiction. I know that this is hard for you to accept, but until she wants to quit, until the pain of her using is more than using...
Oh, bull! Yeah. She loves you. Talk to her.
Sean, she lied to you, she lied to me, and what's worse right now, she's lying to herself. Now, believe me, I have been there. There is nothing that you can do.
There's treatment. She needs help. I could pay for it.
If she'll go.
I'm not running out on her.
so good. You know, you're gonna make somebody a wonderful husband someday. Know that? Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna take a quick shower, okay? Hey, how was school?
Fine.
You okay? Seem a little preoccupied. Hey, when are we gonna finish this thing? It's your turn, you know.
You're going to take a shower.
Yeah. I just remembered that Lewis asked me to come over to consult about our boss from hell. You know, Edwin, Nazi dweeb.
Why not just call him?
Yeah, you know, I suppose I could do that, but, well, he asked me to come over, so might as well. I mean, get me out of the house a while. I really won't be long, but here, I'm going to try this. This looks good. Let's see how this is. Very good. Salad dressing, you need it. I'll get it.
I want to see Nat.
Honey, I know he's a really nice guy and everything, but it was kind of awkward the way it ended, and I wouldn't want him to start upsetting you.
Why would he do that?
I told you, he's carrying around a lot of baggage from his past.
He still loves you.
Oh, he does not love me. Love isn't about controlling. It's about caring and trusting. Is this what he's been telling you? Lies? Where's the rest of it?
Flushed.
Talk about money down the drain.
Yeah, my money.
Sean, I wanted to tell you about that. It turns out I did have to borrow some of your money, just to keep the car going. But I don't know what scare stories Nat's been telling you, but really, honey, you gotta lighten up. This is really no big deal.
It's heroin, Mom, refined opium.
Look, I don't need any pharmaceutical lectures. And where did you get these?
School.
You didn't tell anyone, did you?
Why not if it's no big deal?
You know damn well why not. It may be harmless, but it's still illegal.
Harmless? Oh, so that must mean it's okay for me to
take. Stop that!
Don't quit.
Oh, Sean. Is that what this is all about, this big production number? Honey, okay, so I take a hit now and again. It's no different than taking a drink or smoking a little grass. Really, it's not as if I'm addicted or anything. I'll prove it to you, okay? I'll prove it to you. Look.
Now what? You eat it?
No, silly. Look, if I'd known this was upsetting you, and now I do, it's over. It's done, okay? No more. Now, sir, will you get your mother a clean bowl of soup, please? What do you know about pressure or work? No money because your father's a loser. And Nat,
that's not bad enough that he dumps me, he's got to turn you against me, too. So, hey, if I need a little something to help me get through, if I need something to help me get through the night, who the hell are you to tell me no?
No.
Give me the keys! I'm sorry. Honey, I'm sorry. I am sick. Do you understand? I am sick and I need something to help me get better. So please.
Let's go.
You can't go with me.
I guess you're not going.
Kid with her.
He's my son. Are you guys stealing or what?
Hey, bitch, chill.
Show some respect.
I apologize.
Yeah? Well, then get out of them clothes.
What?
Hey! You heard the man.
That's much better. And we're businessmen. You buy, we sell. Mutual respect. And what's the magic word?
Please.
Now we buy. You sell.
No.
No?
No.
No?
See, we don't understand. No.
Leave her alone. Shall I get out of here?
Well, well, look at here. Hey, you want some of me, boy? Well, you come on and get it.
No, leave me alone.
Let's do both.
No, please. No, please. Don't hurt him. Don't hurt him, please. Stop.
Nuh-uh. Give me the stuff.
No.
Give me the stuff.
No. Oh. You okay? Come on, Mom.
Oh,
Don't want you forgetting us.
Come on, jump. No.
Come on, Mom, let's go.
Satisfied. Help me out of here. Oh. What are you looking at?
Get in the car.
Well, you? Are you telling me to get in the car? Sean, honey, give me the bag, okay? I just feel really sick and I...
Will you just get in the damn car? Lock the doors. I'm calling Lewis.
Husband finds out you're a junkie.
Huh? Please, please help me. Help me, Lewis,
I don't know, I don't know where to start.
Oh no! Oh no! I need help. I just need a little help tonight. Make me. I'm in such pain. Lewis, please. Sean has a bag.
No, Sean
has a bag.
Have it.
Sean.
Here.
Not leaving her.
Sean, there's nothing that you can do.
Sean?
Sean?
What's next? Sharing needles?
You have some. You deserve it.
They're gonna wake her up.
Can I come in?
Thank God, the cavalry.
Where is she?
She's sleeping.
Oh, she's sleeping?
She was completely irrational, screaming, in pain. What was I supposed to do, leave him to cope? Okay, look, I'm not completely dense. I know that giving her more drugs isn't gonna help. And what else could I do?
How bad is it, Lewis?
Yeah, I gotta go. Have her call in sick. I'm gonna tell Edwin that she's got the flu. Nah, she has to understand this can't go on, because she's gonna get herself fired if she doesn't die first.
All right, thank you, Lewis.
It's my fault, isn't it?
No, it's not your fault, and it's not my fault. It's not because your mom had a bad day. Listen to me. There's some people that have an emptiness, and they try to fill it with food or with alcohol or drugs. And in your mom's case,
heroin.
Heroin, yeah. Listen, she's going to be sleeping for a while. Why don't you get your coat? Let's go for a little walk.
For this?
It's the only way, right?
It's the only way that I know of.
Hey, there she is. You feel like eating?
Oh, come on. My cooking's not that bad. Come on, come on, sit down.
I'm just so sorry. I'm just so ashamed.
Gwen, we don't want to hear about it, all right?
Hey, I'm trying to apologize.
Well, let me put it another way. We don't need to hear it, okay? We know you're sorry and you're ashamed and you want to apologize and all the rest of it. So, you don't need to tell us again.
Yeah, well, maybe I wasn't talking to you.
Mom, just listen, okay?
What have you been telling him?
Nothing.
Sean, didn't I tell you he tried to come between us?
I love you. But you lied to me and you stole from me. And last night, if those guys had decided to kill you, there wasn't anything I could do.
It wasn't that bad, Sean.
Yes, Mom, it was. I was there.
Sean.
Mom, please, just get help.
Sean, honey, listen to me.
No, you listen to me. It's my turn.
I love you. Part of me hates to admit that, but it's true. I do. I love you. But you abused that love. You lied to me. You knew the pain that drugs and alcohol had caused me in the past, and still you lied to me. I'm very concerned about you. But that's not the main reason I'm here, because in the end, really, there's nothing that I can do for you. You can have to do it all for yourself. But Sean is a different story, isn't he? And I'm here to tell you right now that if you keep using this stuff, I'm going to do everything that I can to protect him.
You're the one he needs protecting from.
Even if that means telling his father.
No. Sean, honey, I need to talk to Nat for a minute, please.
No. No more secrets.
This is about you and me. It's about us. I don't think he needs to hear this, do you?
Why don't you go outside and wait a few minutes? I'll come get you. All right? You did a good job.
Do you love me?
Yes.
Do you really love me?
Yeah.
Am I that disgusting?
No, Gwen, there is nothing that I would like more than for us to find out who we are for each other, but
we,
not like this yet.
We.
You gotta get clean.
You don't love me. You don't even know who I am. The woman you love is charming and fun and stoned high. Because that's all you've seen. That's all I've been from day one.
That's not true. That's what you tried to show me, but that's not what I've seen.
Oh, please.
No, I've seen your son, who wouldn't be what he is today if it wasn't for you. I've seen your willingness to sacrifice your ego in a job that you hate because you've got responsibilities. And when we make love, you're not pretending. You're not acting. I know who you are. I know your needs. I felt your needs. I want to help you with your needs, but not like this.
My calamity is my providence.
Yes, outwardly it's fire and vengeance, but inwardly it is light and mercy.
Then show me some.
I am trying.
How? By trying to turn my son against me by threatening to take him away?
You think that I was looking to fall in love with an addict? Any more than you're looking to fall in love with a guy that you cannot fool, who will walk away from you if you keep using.
I feel so sick.
Yeah.
I need a little something to get me through, just so I can taper
no.
off.
Mm-mm.
Well, what do you expect me to do?
I expect you to choose between me and your son and the rest of your life.
Fine. You don't understand what it's like to live my life, to live a life where you feel like you're nothing, where you're nobody, you're going nowhere. Love, what do you know about love? If you loved me, you would help me.
I am trying to help you.
You self-righteous son of a bitch. No wonder your wife drank. You probably drove her to it. She probably killed herself to get away from you. Go ahead.
No, and I'm not going to give you more excuses. No, I am leaving right now. And I'm going to be back around 5. I'm going to take Sean with me. And when we come back here, I hope that you're still here. And I hope, because I love you very much, because we both love you, I hope that you are very, very sick.
What will that prove?
Prove that you're willing to suffer the pain.
Yeah, and so what if I do? So what? So odds are I'm just going to go back and use again.
Oh, well, you can beat the odds.
I can't. Don't you understand? This has got me. There is nothing I can do about it.
Except quit. All right, here is my phone number. And here's the number for Narcotics Anonymous. Here, take it. Take it. I love you.
No,
we both
don't
love you.
Go. Please don't go. Please don't go. No.
Just a friend.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Well, you know, I'm a little rocky, but nothing for you to worry about. I just want you to have fun, okay? Just have fun, and can you do that for me?
Yeah.
Good. Okay. Then I will see you later, okay, honey? I love you.
I love you too.
Okay. Bye.
She's okay.
Good. Good.
I... I've changed my mind. I don't come here to go.
I thought you had to go pick up some medicine.
No, I think I'll be okay.
Honey, whatever you got, you look like death warmed over. Come on, get in. Let's go find your doctor friend. Gwen.
It's just a cramp.
Gwen, honey, let's go, okay? Get in. Here.
Yeah, he's an intern. There's no money. That's where we met in the ER.
He gets free samples from the pharmaceutical companies.
Think you're doing here?
I need 20.
No way. Maybe you think I'm crazy or stupid. I'm gonna let you waltz in here and set me up.
What the hell are you talking about?
Your boyfriend, Lewis, threatening to get me busted if I sell you anymore.
Lewis?
So you can just peddle your junky ass somewhere else. This door is closed.
It is. Are you sure about that? She's in the bedroom.
Hi.
I'm Doris.
Hi. Nat.
What happened?
I think that she would rather tell you herself.
Patsy, come on, honey. Let's go.
I was waiting, Mom.
Well, we'll play another game at home.
Okay.
Give her that for me. And tell her I'm buying cappuccinos on Saturday.
I will.
Please take good care of her. She's my friend.
I will.
Okay. I'm awake.
Shivering.
Yes, it's just withdrawal. Hey.
And yourself?
How you doing?
Oh, lovely. Hey, guys. Help me up, okay?
Where are we going?
You'll see.
All right.
I want you to finish it.
Now?
Mm-hmm.
But when my mother started using dope, she lost her way. But with little help from her friends, she really got well. And that's how it ends.
My calamity is my providence. Such light. Such mercy. I love you.